Welcome back, everyone. We're going to move on and continue our Vandal Hearts playthrough. Now, if for some reason you're just randomly jumping in at this piece, I do want to take a second and remind everyone that I would recommend starting over from the start, simply because, well, it's more of an advanced level 100% run with more focus on the technical and mechanical side of it, which we've already focused a lot on. So, continuing on to Orome Lake. So this one is a combination of something we've done before, several things we've done before in fact, and a little bit of new stuff, because we do have to escort Lena. Lena is the NPC, so we don't actually get to control her. We have to get her to the front gate through a couple of past special specific parts and passages on the way, and at the same time we have to keep her alive, as well as Ash.
Thank you.
one of the key strategies here is obviously to clear the enemies as quick as possible, but you also want to inhibit Lena's movement potential. You want to make sure that she can't move up close to enemies, that you basically stuff up all available paths except where you want her to move. So you can kind of guide her movement in a sense that way. Luckily enough, she's also not the weakest character in the world. It's not like she's a level 1 NPC with 13 HP. Thank you. and now she opens up another passage for us to continue on through the level. So we have to repeat this kind of step a few times. To make it all the way to the end, while getting the treasure chests in the meantime. Gold axe, if you remember from earlier, that's basically just a sell for money. The level design is so crowded that now we're actually being impeded. We're being funneled through to single file. This last treasure chest is, to some extent, partially timed, simply because Lena is going to try and move forward and we have to, obviously, keep her safe, clear out the enemies, and then make it over in time. Yeah. Now, even though Diego and Eamon are in very precarious positions, it's done for the safety of Lena. And that's basically it for this level. We just now have to get Lena to the chamber doors. Of course, in the meantime, that lets us get our last remaining treasure chest. Level complete. A pretty easy level, especially when you consider some of the ones we just had fairly recently. The Crimson Guard, by comparison, were considerably more difficult. I love how there was a very small typo in the text just there. In the previous line, it said, "Now your last chance is gone," but it was "you apostrophe R." And there is the end of our fifth act. Now, we will continue on, of course, but we're not going to break the part here just yet.
The great sword, Vandal Heart, the only power which can resist the flames of judgment. Ash and his friends set off for the city of Shumeria to take their part in the Liberation Army's final assault. At the same time, Dolph, who had been secretly hiding his true ambition for years, saw the chaos after the death of Emperor Hell as his great chance to grasp the reins of power.
Act 6, A Fool's Epitaph. So, let's see what we have in our newfound town here. We have a whole rig of new weapons and armor for everyone. Of course, it doesn't apply to Ash, as he's got the Vandal Heart. Thank you. even after a full upgrade for every character, we still didn't even run out of money. So we've now got our Key of the Heaven for our sixth and final Trial of Tauroa. This guy actually only gives you this one, this key, if you've completed all trials and you have all five prisms like you mentioned. So we know what's coming in the next part. We are going to finally reveal the mystery of the Trials of Tauroa. So in our next part, we will be finally completing this last trial and uncovering the final secret.